very close to the Temple Mount, and that means that wherever we dig, we can find some history. About 2 years ago, we dug into the wall in the middle of this bridge, and we dug down, down, down into the ground. In one spot, we discovered 6 periods of history, from the first temple period to the second temple period, the Romans, the Byzantines, the Crusaders, and the Mamluks. I don't know too many places in the world today where you can dig in one spot, find 6 periods of history, and pottery that corresponds with every period of time. Also, about 2 years ago, we dug on the other side of this bridge, we dug down into the ground, and we discovered a ritual pool. In the times of the Second Temple, everybody who went up to the Temple Mount had to immerse in a ritual pool. There were hundreds of pools found in this area. What we discovered here in the tunnels is the biggest pool to date outside the Temple Mount. So some archaeologists say, wow, such a big pool. Maybe it was used by the priests or the Levites before they went up to the temple. Now, I don't know if any of you have ever watched archaeologists digging. Maybe you've been on a dig. But I went down into the ground when they were digging near the pool, and I watched them pulling out of the ground clay jugs with Jerusalem design. We found the bottom of an amphora jug, a pointed jug that was used for wine storage. Placed a pointed jug in the ground. It keeps the wine cool and it doesn't spill. And we found ancient coins. So it's quite amazing, the places where you dig here, history comes to life. What we're going to do is this. Our group is going to go over the bridge. On your right-hand side, you'll see a large window. It says Hall of Ages. That's where we found the 6 periods of history. And on the other side of the bridge, if you look in the back of the room, there is a window. If you look down in the window, you will see the ritual pool that we discovered here. So watch your step, please, and join me over the bridge.
I'm looking at the truck line.